Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing with myself.
Nothing I can do about that.
This is where the magic happens. Well, science. But it still happens.
If you need it, okay.
Hey, you hear about Wilson?
Heard Marauders got in.
Just between us, Wilson deserted. Lost his nerve. Ran off in the thick of night.
You kidding me? Damn. Always thought he was made of sturdy stuff.
I think he was plagued. Guess he didn't want to die in the sick house.
Plagued? Ah, shit. I had some of his soul, too.
You moron.
One of us want to go see what happened?
Food's bound to spoil at this rate.
Adelaide's okay.
What happened? Sprat fell into a transformer again? I know, I'm trying to think.
Hope Adelaide's okay.
One of us want to go see what happened?
Food's bound to...
Any luck finding one of those manuals? No kidding! Really? Well, which one? Ain't that just ironical? If I'd worked a little longer back at the cannery, I might have found this myself. That's a complete set! All three parts! I'm gonna be the greatest engineer Halcyon's ever seen! Aside from you, Ms. Parvati, I swear, I'll do you proud.
I'm glad we could help, Thomas.
I've been saving something for you. Just a little contraption I found. Should fit right into your outfit. Adelaide said that? Was she sober at the time? I never imagined she'd step foot in Edgewater long as Reed ran the town. Something must have changed in Edgewater. Adelaide's good as family. If she's going back, so are we.
Thank you. Thank you.
coming!
Thank you.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing with myself.
I know how you feel. Another day at the cannery.
Don't go knocking your work.
Spacer's Choice, the brand of choice for spacers on a budget. Music to my ears. It's a fine new day in Edgewater. The cannery hums, streetlights and faces glow. I suppose this means the two of you were able to sort out the matter? The greater good can be difficult to determine. None of us can know the effects of our decision in a year, or 10, or 100. Take comfort in the fact that your choices are always, ultimately, in line with the grand plan. Wonderful! This is fantastic! Well worth all the sacrifices I... Wait. What the fuck is this? Is this... French? I can't fucking read French! It's a law-forsaken joke is what it is. French! Ha! I was so high and mighty, preaching to the yokels about following the plan, while fighting it at every turn. there is little more important than such a precious, rare text. I've spent my life searching for the keys to unlocking the secrets of the universal equation that underlies the plan. I had hoped this book held some of those answers. I became so desperate, I even got myself assigned to this plague-ridden backwater to find the damn thing. All the time and suffering I've spent. Wasted. Bokonu, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the philosophist school of thought, so the book is banned in this colony. Philosophism's a false religion that stands in contradiction to almost everything we know to be true. They believe all is chaos, in stark contrast to OSI's belief in the plan. But most of the philosophist perversion of Bokonu's thoughts came more than a century after his death. Please, as if my life should have no greater meaning than proselytizing to a bunch of feeble-minded wretches. Nothing could be more excruciating than discussing the true nature of reality with people who have no interest beyond their next Aetherwave program. But that's neither here nor there. What I need to do now is to find a translator, obviously. But to do that, I'll first need to secure transport. You have a ship. Perhaps I could make myself of use to your crew. Free spiritual counseling, someone to watch your back, not to mention a grown-up in the party.
I'm 28.
Exactly. I'm pretty handy with a tossball stick, or any blunt instrument, really. I'm also a passable gun hand, if it comes to that. I can usually talk my way out of conflict, though. Oh, I'm fairly competent at hacking computers as well. Fantastic. I promise you won't regret this.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change of scenery, and to leave this place behind. It is my esteemed pleasure to serve as your crew vicar, Captain.
When I was little, we'd get freighters in every Sunday noon. Now they only come but once a month. I love the wind here.
Is this your ship? Oh my star, she is just so handsome. Does she have a name yet? What's her drive model? Oh, gosh. Listen to me babbling. When I was in Edgewater, I dreamed of flying on a real ship, working on a real engine, belonging to a proper crew. I'm the only decent mechanic Edgewater's got, but every time I think of going back, I get this sinking feeling. Well, it's kind of you to say that. And you're right. I wasn't happy. I want to ask you something, and you can say no. But can I come with you? I could tend to your engine. I know my G-valves from my catalyzers, and I can keep your ship singing. And if you ever need a pair of eyes watching your back, I can do that too. What do you think? Yes! I mean, thanks. You won't regret this, mister. Captain. I can call you Captain now. Ha! I got a captain.